So you've heard me say in my other videos that weight loss is basically calories in versus calories out and eating at a calorie deficit over a sustained time frame. Now there are other factors that can play a role in that and we can help to optimize our weight loss, but when it comes down to it, to burn that fat, to lose the weight, you need to be eating at a calorie deficit. And that means that understanding how many calories your specific body needs is very important to understanding what you need to be targeting in order to achieve that calorie deficit and ultimately weight loss. But in a nutshell, macros or macronutrients are the proteins, carbs, and fats that make up our total calories for every day. So when I sit down to do my macros, my first question is, what is my number one goal that I want to achieve? And these macros are gonna help me achieve that. Now, this isn't always the easiest question. I tend to want too many things and I tend to try to have too many goals at once. But ultimately, do I wanna lose weight, do I wanna maintain my weight, or do I wanna gain weight? Now, I might also wanna be building muscle, in which case we can talk about that in a little bit about building muscle versus losing fat, but I have to decide, number one, what is my main goal? So my main goal at this point is to maintain my current weight while continuing to lose body fat. So that means that while reducing my body fat percentage, which means the amount of body fat that is the percentage of my total body weight, I want to reduce that and I want to instead replace a lot of that weight with muscle. And I do that through following macros with my food intake, strength training, and intermittent fasting. Now it's also important to pay attention to the type of exercise that I'm doing. My main type of exercise, if you've watched my other videos, is strength training. I love weightlifting because, first off, if you watch my video on cardio, you know I'm not a huge fan of cardio. I don't like going on runs very much. I don't like doing HIIT. It's just not my energy source. What I do like is lifting heavy weights and getting stronger and stronger and building muscle. So weightlifting is a really valuable tool for me and it works really well with my goals. So that means that my exercise goals are actually targeting building more muscle. Now muscle weighs the same as fat. 1 pound of muscle is 1 pound of fat, but the space that muscle takes up in your body and the volume and density it has versus fat is very different. So if I lost 5 pounds of fat but gained 5 pounds of muscle, it would not look the same. I would look a lot leaner, I would look a lot healthier, and also having more muscle on your body increases your metabolism, allows you to actually eat more during the day, which is always a win. So that's why I say I wanna lose body fat percentage, but I don't care too much about losing weight at this point anymore. When I was 50, 60, 70 pounds overweight, I definitely cared about losing weight and I wanted to get down to a number that I was comfortable with. P.S. If you wanna learn about weightlifting, because now I totally got you interested, which you totally should, check out my playlist with my workouts and I have a bunch of intro information on weightlifting and how to get started, plus some sample workouts that I do. So if you followed my video on how to calculate your own macros, which I can link to that in the description below and on the screen, you already know that we use an equation to calculate how many calories we need to eat in a day. And that number gives us our BMR, or our basal metabolic rate, and then you adjust that based off of your activity levels. And that total number gives you your total daily energy expenditure, your TDEE. But basically the TDEE is the total number of energy that you are putting out every day through every activity that you do, and that's from if you're walking your dog, if you are exercising, if you're just sitting there breathing on the couch all day, your total daily energy expenditure is that number. So in order to have that calorie deficit for the calories in versus calories out, you need to be eating less than that TDEE in order to lose weight. You need to be eating the same amount as that and targeting that number to maintain your weight, or you need to be eating more than that to gain weight. So if you've ever noticed that you've been really not eating well and you keep gaining weight and you think it's just because of those Oreos, it's actually not just because of the specific food. While eating healthy foods and having nourishing foods is helpful, it really comes down to those calories. And are you eating over your TDEE? And that's what's gonna be causing your weight gain. Plus, if you ever want me to calculate your custom macros so that you have an understanding of how many calories you need, and all of this sounds super confusing and you just want somebody to do it for you, check out my 30-day healthy program and click on the upgrade to calculate your custom macros and I can take care of that for you. I'll leave a link below in the description and I'll put it on the screen at the end of this as well. So just for some numbers and so you kind of understand how to approach using macros, I weigh 145 pounds, I'm 37 years old, and I'm 5'9". So that calculation leaves me with a BMR, or basal metabolic rate, of 1,407. Now that is the base level of what it takes to keep me alive each day, for my body to just do general basic functioning. Once you then apply my activity factors and my weight training and all of that, my TDEE becomes 2,181. So that means that every day I burn 2,181 calories just doing my normal life. So in order to lose weight, I would want to eat less than that. In order to maintain, I want to eat just about that number. And in order to gain weight, I would eat more than that. And in order to calculate that, I estimated my body fat percentage to be at 23%. You can calculate your body fat percentage a number of ways. You can buy a scale, just a normal weight scale that can calculate it for you. Those numbers aren't usually very good, but they do give you a baseline. You can go and get an expensive test done, or you can just kind of get a general understanding based off of a ton of different online images that allow you to see kind of where you fit in a scale. So now that I have all those numbers and I understand how many calories I need to target, then I need to break it down into the macros. Of those calories, how many of those are going to be protein and fat and carbs, and in what percentages? So most studies generally recommend that you have about 0.7 to 1.0 grams of protein per pound of lean body mass on your body. So in order to calculate your lean body mass, you would just take your body fat percentage, multiply it by your total weight, and then remove that amount. So you're basically taking that body fat percentage out of your total weight. So if you did that with my 23% of 145, that gives you 111.6 pounds, which would mean my lean body mass is 111.6. So that would mean if I was eating at that high range that I would be having 111.6 grams of protein each day. But that percentage isn't the percentage that I like to target. I actually personally like to target a higher percentage. And that's because based off of my experiences and my weight training, I want to have more protein. Eating higher percentages of protein used to be thought to actually cause colon cancer and have all of these issues. But the research shows that that's not the case, that there's actually no detriment to having more protein than your body actually needs. Plus, when you eat protein compared to other macronutrients, your body has a higher thermogenic effect. And what that means is it's actually burning more calories to consume and process and break down that protein. So you're actually burning more calories having protein than you are with fat or carbs. So for me, I enjoy protein. It makes you feel full, you feel satisfied after eating it, it takes longer to digest, and your body actually burns more calories to break it down. So I target higher levels of protein. So my target typically ranges around 35 to 40% protein. And then I aim for 30 to 35% fats. And then the remainder of whatever that is what I have for my percentage of carbohydrates. Usually it ranges around 30%. And within that 30%, I always target 20 to 30 grams of fiber every day from real foods. So if you broke down my macro goals right now, it would be 2,181 total calories that I'm targeting each day with 36% protein, which equals 196.3 grams of protein. And that is equivalent to 785.2 calories. Now you get that by multiplying the number of grams times 4. Every 1 gram of protein equals 4 calories. So in order to understand how many calories from the grams you're eating is to multiply protein by 4. In order to understand fats, you would multiply fats by 9 because a gram of fat is worth 9 calories. And carbs, just like protein, are worth 4 calories. So whenever you want to understand how many calories are in something and you know the number of grams, now you know. So going back to my macros, I'm currently targeting my total calories, 33% of that to be coming from fat. And that's roughly 80 grams of fat, which equals about 720 calories. And then the remainder of that, which would be 100 minus 36 minus 33, is 31% carbs. And that is about 170 grams of carbs, which is about 676 calories. So if I were just starting out and I was trying to understand what to do with this, I would download an app that would allow me to track everything. MyFitnessPal is a great option. That's what I use, but there's a ton of them out there. And I would follow it as closely as I could. I wouldn't drive myself insane trying to test everything and trying to make sure I get it perfect. I would still try to do it just generally. Remember, these are percentages. They're just a guideline. And I would see how close I could get to that and then see how I feel. I typically would try to do this for about 2 weeks to kind of test everything. I feel like just 1 or 2 days is not long enough, and a month is too long for changes. So I like to do about 2 weeks, and that gives me some time to really assess whether something's working. After 2 weeks, I take an assessment, and I don't just rely on my weight to understand if this macro count was successful. Instead, I rely on a whole gambit of things that allow me to take this bigger picture of understanding, was I successful? Do I like these macros? Did I gain weight? Did I lose weight? One fluctuates so much with weight that it's really hard to compare one day to the next. So I like taking taking an average for each week. I take progress pics so that I can see how I look before and after, because sometimes even how you look in the mirror is different than how a progress pic is. I assess my strengths in my workouts. Am I able to lift more weight? Have I had a lot of energy while working out? Am I maxing out on things, or do I feel super weak and not able to lift the stuff that I used to be able to lift? How do I fit in my clothes? Are they fitting kind of snug and I feel like, oh my goodness, I'm putting a little bit of weight on, nothing's comfortable? Or are they fitting really nicely and a little loose and I feel like I'm looking good? How is my general energy level? Do I feel like I have a ton of energy and I could just kill it with this lifestyle, that it's feeling really good? Or do I feel like I'm constantly tired and I have no energy to do anything and I can't stand life right now? And if you've been there with carb cutting, you know how that feels. I assess whether or not I'm hungry all the time. Am I constantly thinking about food and feeling so hungry that my stomach is growling and I feel like I can't handle being hungry all the time? Even if after I have a glass of water, do I still feel hungry? Even though I'm eating to my macro amounts and I'm not under eating. I can also take measurements and measure my waist and my arms and my legs, and those measurements will help give me an objective understanding of where my body is compared to those two time frames. And then I ask myself, did I enjoy doing this? Did I feel like I was overeating? Did I feel like I was constantly trying to make it to that macro count, or did it feel like a good fit? And then based off of that information, I kind of either continue another 2 weeks and see how it goes, or I tweak it a little bit and kind of change things up. If I just feel so full that I can't stand it, maybe I cut my protein and my fat levels a little bit and I increase the carbs. Or if I'm absolutely starving the entire time and I feel like no matter how many times I get to that amount, I still feel hungry, then I would reduce some of the carbs and increase more of the healthy fats. And I kind of tweak it from that point to kind of make it work for me. If it doesn't work for me, it's not gonna be sustainable and I'm not gonna be successful. But it does give you something to focus on and kind of understand what you're consuming so that you can reach your goals. And there's no perfect answer and there's no perfect macro percentage, but finding what works for you is a great part of being successful in your healthy lifestyle. So come join us in 30 Day Healthy and click that upgrade for the custom macros if you want me to personally calculate them for you, and I will see you in the next video.